If you record external audio for your videos, you know that syncing it can be an infernal struggle. I've personally spent hours nudging clips together with the period and comma keys until they line up perfectly. But there's a much easier way to do this in Final Cut Pro. So like MTV in the late 90s, it's time to get in sync. These puns are like music to my ears, and speaking of music for your ears, this video is sponsored by Artlist. If you know me, you know that sponsored content is very rare on my channel, so before I tell you about Artlist, let me tell you why Artlist really does hold a special place in my heart. Back when I was just starting my YouTube channel, the very first money I invested into this whole thing was for my Artlist subscription, because when I started the channel in June of 2017, before I had even made a video, it was important to me to know that I was gonna take this thing seriously. And that's why Artlist will always have a very special place in my heart list. But more importantly, Artlist offers really high quality, royalty-free music and sound effects with a perpetual worldwide license. Everything you download is yours to use forever, even if you don't end up renewing your annual subscription. So if you wanna check Artlist out and see if it's right for you, there's a link in the description that will also get you 2 extra months on your annual subscription. So thank you, Artlist, for supporting me, for being a part of my journey, and for sponsoring today's video, which is all about Final Cut. And guess what? You could use some royalty-free music in your Final Cut projects. Transition. So I've got my Final Cut open. I'm gonna create a new project. We'll just call this Unsynced. I'm going to import my clips, which is important to remember. So for this example, I've got 4 clips that I recorded for my podcasting course. I have a screen recording, the main camera, an audio file, and a B camera, my camera that's over here on the side. So I'm gonna select all those and import them. So now they're all here in Final Cut. They do all have audio recording. Some of them, like my B camera, as you can see here, have very big audio files. My screen share had audio recording, but my main camera wasn't connected to a microphone and its audio level was turned really low, so it actually has a really low volume. And it doesn't really seem to matter. So sit back, because this is a little bit complicated. I'm going to select my clips, right click, and click synchronize. And then I'm just gonna give it a name. I usually like to call it, you know, main part synced. I usually like to use the word synced in it. Click okay. It's gonna take a second to go through all that. And now I have main part synced. I can drag this down here. It looks like one clip and it's gonna have really loud volume as well. But when I double click on it, here's all my clips, totally synced up. So now all of my clips are already synced. They're not the exact same length, so Final Cut just takes the longest one and puts that as the main source, and then the rest kind of fit in wherever they go. They're pretty close in length, but you can see here, like, I ended them at different times. And if we go to the beginning, I started them at different times. The screen recording started first, so that's the one that is the longest. Now, all I need to do is just mute the audio from all of these other files, and I just wanna keep this audio down here, which was recorded into the Rodecaster Pro. So that's really it in terms of syncing things. If I click this little back arrow, then I go back to my timeline, and here's how I edit my clips from this point, as I double click on them to open them up and I add in my basic like color corrections and stuff. So in this case, I have a preset that I'm gonna add. It works just the same as normal video. So now I have them colored the way that I want and I can just go through and start editing like normal. So if you wanna cut through multiple layers at once, you can just put the playhead where you want and press Shift Command B and it will cut through all those layers and then just delete. In this case, it connected everything to the screen sharing clip because that was the longest clip. So whatever you want to be your main thing that everything is connected to, start recording there first. I'm going to delete that and it deletes everything. So now I've gone through and I've made my basic assembly edit, but it's all pretty much just on my main shot. So this is where I'm gonna go through and start switching between them. Now, why wouldn't I just use Multicam for this? I did an entire video all about how to use Multicam editing in Final Cut. It's a great resource. This would fit in Multicam really well because it also syncs stuff up. For me, for whatever reason, this is sometimes just easier, which, by the way, it will match it so things don't go out of sync. Sometimes your audio needs to be sped up or slowed down by like 0.01% and it will do that automatically so you don't have to worry about it, which is pretty great. But even though multicam editing is simple and probably for a situation like this, the better choice, the thing with video editing and video production is there's usually more than one way to do just about everything. And I kind of feel that if it works, it works. So don't stress yourself out over being perfect and being technically correct. If what you're doing is working, it's working. That's really all that matters. And I like this because it lays everything out in front of me. There's something I've been trying to do in my editing, which is avoiding jump cuts more than I used to. And I know on YouTube, jump cuts are fine, but I feel like it adds a little more visual interest not to have them. So let's do this part right here.
A free platform or a paid one. So let's start with free.
So that jump cut is fine. Like, it doesn't look bad, but to make things a little more interesting, I could go up here. So I'm gonna press V to activate this clip.
Or a paid one. So let's start with free because that's what everyone always wants to know first.
Okay, and then there I can press B and just cut this clip. Go back to A, press V to deactivate it. And then this one, I'm also going to make inactive and jump to the screen share. So now I go from my main shot
or a paid one. So let's start with free
to my B camera.
That's what everyone always wants to know first. The most
and to my screen share. And that's a lot more interesting than just a regular jump cut. Similarly, what I might do is I have another jump cut here.
And of course, Anchor will help you distribute your podcast to
I might just press Shift Command B, and then this one I might punch in a little bit. I know that for me, if I do 138% scale and then just push it down a little bit so that my hair just touches the top,
that to be super fun. And of course, Anchor will help.
That kind of also covers up jump cuts. So by having these two cameras, I basically have three camera angles. I have my main shot, I have a punched in version of the main shot, and I have my B camera over here, and I've got the screen share. So without even filming any other B-roll footage, I've got four different angles to cut between. And I kind of just go through this and do that, jump back and forth where I need to. If I think I might later on decide that I want a shot, I usually just leave it inactive by pressing V. And what this does is it's kind of a note to myself. So I know obviously when I'm editing that my main shot is the one that's being selected, but this B camera clip is still there. The fact that it's there and inactive means that I'm telling myself, hey, you're not using this, but if something doesn't look right and you feel like you need to use this, go ahead and do that. Whereas if I know, like here, I don't want to do this because the camera went out of focus or I look really stupid or whatever, then I'll just delete it and it's not an issue at all. So that's what I'll do with everything that's synced together, and then I'll go back to the main timeline. Now, once you've done that, you've cut stuff out and trimmed things together. So what you'll notice is there's a whole lot of black because this is how much stuff I cut out. So it's very important to then go, and I just use the arrow keys to go to the last frame and then Command B to cut it. Boom, and then it'll just go right into the next shot. Now you can add in audio and stuff. I could bring in sound effects. I could bring in music to this like nested clip right here. But I personally like to do all that stuff on the main timeline with all of the other clips instead. And so there we go. That's my now edited clip. I can double click on it, go back and play with it, hop out here and jump on my timeline. I can do Command B and then split that clip. I can even move another thing into it. So if you're somebody who does a lot of external audio recording, this can be a total lifesaver because it's so quick and it's so easy. And like I mentioned before, it automatically makes sure your audio doesn't drift out of sync. If you're working with longer clips, 10 minutes, 20 minutes and beyond, sometimes you'll notice it starts off in sync and you spend all the time lining it up, and then over time it sort of drifts and you have to cut it and reposition it, cut it and reposition it. There's a lot of reasons that can happen, but this at least takes care of it so you don't have to worry about it anymore, which is great. So finally, I'm gonna cut to the chase and say, I hope you can see all the pros to this method in Final Cut Pro. If you wanna learn more about Final Cut so you can be the Final Cut Pro, check out these videos right here in this professional playlist.